Hi, welcome to Sci-Fi Instinct.
Welcome.
Today, we are going to talk about the physics of an upcoming game, Anthem, the concept of which we find quite interesting. It revolves around flying exoskeleton suits called javelins. So, are they possible or not?
And if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Because we keep coming with new and interesting topics bordering between sci-fi and science every week.
So, exoskeleton suits that give you superhuman strength while at the same time allowing you to fly. Sounds like a totally sci-fi concept, doesn't it? This is the main topic of the upcoming game Anthem from BioWare.
Although I have to say that I have some minor problems with the publisher Electronic Arts, you know, some minor problems like, for example, absolutely hating EA for destroying my favorite game developers ever, like Westwood, Origin, Bullfrog, and Visceral Games, and many more. But I try to overlook that now for the purpose of this video, and try to keep my emotions in check.
Let's see if BioWare is able to produce a good game again, after Mass Effect Andromeda now standing up to its expectations.
Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything.
Yeah. In Anthem, the whole central aspect of the game, which of course takes place in the far future, is to fly around in your Iron Man-style javelin to thrash the bad guys.
Wait, what did you say? A skin in this game costs $20? And they also downgraded the graphics compared to the E3 demo from 2017? Okay, I promise to keep calm. Sorry, won't happen again. The concept of flying exosuits was famously popularized in the Marvel comic Iron Man, which now has many movies, like many, many, many movies, and they just keep coming and coming and coming. Avengers Part 47, The Return of Iron Man Part 5.
Here, the main protagonist becomes a hero when entering his flying exosuit made of some super strong metal alloy. But outside of his super suit, he is just a regular human. As in Anthem, the physical powers of the wearer are greatly increased by the suit.
So without further ado, is the concept of a flying exosuit just a faraway sci-fi fantasy? Will we ever be able to fly to work in the morning in a cool exosuit? Or will we ever be able to do a cool exosuit air trip through the US or Europe? Let's take a look at some current developments and find out where we are now on the road to flying exosuits.
On the one hand, we already have a flying suit from the company Gravity. An engineer called Richard Browning one day thought that it would be a cool idea to have a flying suit. As he opened up Amazon.com to order one, he found out that they don't even exist, so he had to make one himself. After experimenting around a lot with different suit elements, different turbines, and turbine arrangements, the first iteration of the exosuit was soon finished, which was only 1 year ago.
And now his company Gravity offers training for wannabe exosuit pilots with their first commercial exosuit called the Jet Suit. The specs are pretty impressive. 1050 horsepower, 5 turbines, a dry weight of only 27 kilograms, a maximum speed of 32 miles per hour, and an altitude limit of around 3,600 meters or 12,000 feet. Okay, but what is the power source? Surely we want this thing to fly for hours and hours like an Anthem or Iron Man. You cannot win against the bad guys if your suit is out of power after 5 minutes, can you? And this is exactly where the problem lies with today's technology. The Gravity flying suit has only 5 to 10 minutes of flight time, even though it is being powered by diesel or jet fuel, which has a quite high energy density. So the problem is not the feasibility of a flying exosuit, but the power source. But more on that later.
Okay, So the flying part is not prevented by physics, and it has been shown to work. But what about the superhuman strength? Surprisingly, it looks pretty good. A lot of advancements are happening in the area of strength-enhancing exosuits because they offer a wide area of potential applications. In industry, for example, to reduce muscle strain, or for military use. Because, you know, we were promised the crisis nanosuit already in 2007, and therefore it needs to happen. And last but not least, for helping people with movement impairment, so that instead of a wheelchair, people might be able to walk again with the exosuit.
And the first companies are already really pushing the boundaries in this new market, like for example Suit X, SpaceX. Probably they will be to the suit industry what SpaceX is to the space industry. They already offer the industrial exoskeleton suit, specifically designed for use in physically straining industrial work, such as carrying heavy equipment or assembling parts head over, which would normally make your shoulders go limp after a few minutes. Not mine, of course. With the Suit X exosuit, however, the strain on your muscles is greatly reduced.
They also offer a medical version called the Phoenix Medical Exoskeleton, which can help paralyzed people work again. And of course, the military wants to create the super soldier as always. Nothing new there. So they are also developing exosuits of their own. So how long can those suits be used before having to refuel or recharge? Well, it turns out they fare much better than the flying exosuit. They can go for 4 hours in a row before having to be recharged, running on a lithium ion battery. So that is already much better than the flying suit.
Now we would like to combine the power enhancing exosuit with a flying exosuit. In fact, the two systems would only need to be combined into one suit and clad into some strong metal alloy. But then a huge problem arises. Even as it is, the gravity exosuit, which is state of the art, flies only for a maximum of about 10 minutes. The weight of this new combined super exosuit would of course be greatly increased, which would then require an even more powerful energy source, if you want to use it for longer periods of time, of course. So the problem is not that the technology itself is impossible or too complicated. The problem is the power source.
We would need some new form of super compact, extremely high density energy source for the flying suits from Anthem. In the game, you don't see those guys wearing a huge battery backpack or a diesel generator. They also don't seem to be tethered somewhere, which would be absolutely impractical. Hey, I need more cable! Only a few more meters, then I can get to the back guy!
Currently, the highest volumetric energy density of regular lithium-ion batteries is about 693 watt-hours per liter. And it has been steadily increasing over the past 30 years, as can be seen in this chart. However, this energy density is still considerably lower than diesel or jet fuel. And even that only yields 5 to 10 minutes of flight time for the gravity exosuit, which would be far lighter than our hypothetical Anthem Javelin flying suit. Let's take a look at the energy density of the most common energy sources.
We see that diesel gives a lot of energy per volume, but is quite heavy, whereas hydrogen gives a lot of energy per mass, but needs a lot of volume. Flying around with huge hydrogen tanks might not be a good idea, because as you know, hydrogen likes to and battery energy density is still too low nowadays.
Without some major technological breakthroughs regarding energy storage, say for example carbon nanotube batteries or something completely new we don't even know of today, we unfortunately won't see such javelins or Iron Man suits anytime soon. However, for automotive applications, the increasing battery density will be more than enough. Because we shouldn't forget that the efficiency of an electric car is much higher than of a gasoline car.
Even though it seems that we still have to wait a bit for our Anthem flying suit, we can at least play games or watch movies where people fly around in cool, shiny, metal-plated exosuits.
So what do you think? Will we have flying exosuits like in Anthem or Iron Man sooner than expected? Or if no, where do you see the problems? And do you agree with us that the energy source will pose the main problem for this suit? Let us know in the comment section what you think.
So, don't forget to hit that like button and share this video with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification, because we will keep coming with more videos on sci-fi and science topics. And also maybe do some movie reviews here and there.
But only sci-fi movies. So see you next time on Sci-Fi Instinct! Bye!
Bye!